We're here at I already forgot how they said it, Jack.
Robibero.
Yeah, I think that's how he said it, but at Robibero, and I know I'm saying that wrong, the winery, I'm sorry. And it's very, very crowded today. It's cloudy, but it hasn't stopped anybody from coming. There are a few parties out there on the lawn. There's a big property here, lots of things going on, including some live music. And we did manage to get a table. We're very excited. And we have ordered a flight. So two of us, we kind of mixed it up. We wanted more of the whites than reds. So we have six whites coming between us and two reds. And we've already gotten our first whites, which was Serendipity and Chardonnay. And I've already tasted them. Jack hasn't, I don't think, yet.
I tasted mine.
Oh, you did?
Yeah.
And even though at first when I was sniffing the aroma of the Serendipity, I thought I was going to maybe not like that one, but I actually do like it. And I think I actually like it more than the Chardonnay, which is surprising because I love Chardonnay.
I'm going to have to get a taste of that
one. So you can taste that one now. But they do it very differently here. You know, it's like they do each pour at the table, and he'll come around once he sees, I guess, that we have finished this first tasting, and then he'll come over and he'll describe the wines, the next two wines that we've chosen. So differently from the other wineries we've been to recently, where they bring you the whole flight and you kind of do it on your own, which we actually kind of like. But this is nice too. And he, you know, it, at least we are getting a little more informed about the wines we're about to taste.
So I don't know if Janine mentioned, but we are in New Paltz, New York today, and our tastings cost $20 each, and you get four tastings, and we, of course, do what we always do, and we split it up four and four, and then we taste each other, so we really get to taste eight wines, which is great. And the pours are a little less than last week, but pretty good. I can't complain yet. And so far, the wines have been very, very good.
Stay grown here. The Cab Franc that they did here and bottled strictly on its own, you know, was tremendous, and they libraried that what's remaining of it, and it sells for a good price because it was such demand. It's really good. So the Cab Franc is what makes that wine, I think. And the Chardonnay is kind of a classic Chardonnay. 8 months in oak, fermented and aged, and it gives it that, you know, buttery tannin oak flavors.
We are already at our last tasting. We're down to our fourth wine, having Rabbit's Foot, which is the red, and the white was
dry Riesling.
We love dry Riesling, so we're anxious to see how that one is. And then we're debating whether or not we want to get a glass of wine and just sit here for a while, because I think, I don't even know if the music's playing, because there's so much talking, and we're far away from where the musicians are. They're way in front on the lawn, and we're kind of in back. We go through the winery, and now we're out on their deck. And there's just so much going on that there's a lot of talking, and I have no idea if music's playing or not. We could have tried to wait for a table up front, which I think there is actually one open, but we already moved tables, so I think we're just going to stay put and try our last wine.
So I think we're going to also get a little bit of cheese. I'm kind of feeling it.
So I'm trying the Riesling. And it's really good. I really like this. Might be one of the favorite ones that I've tried today. Really good, refreshing, a little bit dry, but there's still a little hint of sweetness to it. So I think Jack will like it too. Really good. And in the beginning, I think I said we started with a Chardonnay, and it wasn't a Chardonnay in the beginning. It was Vidal Blanc, I think. So sorry about that. But we did try a Chardonnay later. It was super, super light, but I definitely like the Riesling more. That's definitely my favorite white of the day.
Okay, so I'm going to try our last red, which was, what was it again?
Rabbit Foot.
That's really, really good. It's really light, surprisingly. I don't remember, was it Baco Noir and Merlot, I think, a mixture of, or maybe Cabernet. I don't know, we'll have to look at the menu again, figure that out. Well, I was totally wrong, it's Baco Noir and Pinot Noir. But very tasty, good legs. I would highly recommend that one. Robibero. Great scenery. Dogs barking in the background. And the crackers and cheese were amazing. Anything to add?
Just that apparently you can bring your dogs because there's a small dog at the next table. And there are dogs down on the grounds too. So
we could have brought Bobby the Dobby. But he would have been all over the place. We'll have to take a picture of him and include it in this video so you all see what we deal with when Jocelyn is home from school. That's a wrap for Robibero, as we were told it was pronounced. It was a fun day.
Yeah.
Good wine, great cheese. Good crackers. Mm-hmm. Can't complain.
Really good. Beautiful grounds here too.
Yeah,
they
it's really beautiful.
They do say that when you drive up, it says masks mandatory, but there was no signage when we walked in, so we saw that the people giving the tastings didn't have a mask, and so we took ours off since we're vaccinated.
Right. We are vaccinated 100%.
Okay. So, not actually sure because they weren't really holding to what they had posted as you drive up. I think it's on our system at this point.
Right.
But you're outside for most of the experience, I think, so it's fine. And, the tables are distanced and everything.
There's live music playing in the background. But I guess there's nothing left to say other than cheers.